I just watched a video, this video here by Randy Wicker. And in it, he's talking about trying to move up the blip number one list. And he's talking about different, different tricks that he wants to try to get himself to the top of the list. And in the course of making this video, he mentions Doug, whose video is here, whose vlog is there. And apparently he talked about Doug yesterday, so Doug made a video today where he talks about Randy. And I got to this whole thing, I got to thinking about the internet and what a strange and wonderful thing it is. You know, I started in the year 2000, I started a journal, a regular online journal, daily diary. And the reason I started it is because I met Steve Shacklin, whose journal, Living in the Bonus Round, is the eighth journal to ever be posted on the internet. Now there are thousands, millions maybe. But Steve's was the eighth. And he and I got to be friends, and I decided, well, if Steve could do it, maybe I could do it. So I started my journal, which was from always the beginning called Funny the World. And the one thing I found out about writing a journal, I started it as kind of an exercise to see whether I could actually produce a daily column. Because it runs about the same length every day. Sometimes it's a little bit longer, sometimes it's a little bit shorter. But it's roughly 850 words a day, which is about the length of a newspaper column if I were to be a regular opinion columnist. And I discovered that when you write a journal, if you really want a lot of readers, what you need to do is to write a journal every single day. Because then you get people who get used to checking you every day. People who don't write in their journals all the time, I don't know if they have, their readership is quite as big. And readership for my journal was really kind of important for me. But the thing about doing a journal and about the internet in general is we sort of become a part of a community. And I became a part of a journaling community in the year 2000. And I began to make a lot of friends, people that I may never ever meet. I met Marn. Marn lives in Canada. And she and I are both, she's a little bit younger than I am, but she's in much better shape than I am. I've been meeting Marn forever. She's a fantastic writer, very funny, and I really feel like I know who she is. I've been reading Bozoette. Mary used to be a clown at one point. She hasn't been a clown in a long time, but she does juggle. As a matter of fact, in one of my early videos, I have a picture of her juggling. But I read her every day. And we've become friends. I actually went, when I was in Washington, D.C., I went and saw her. So there are a whole lot of people that I've met as a result of the internet. Some of them I've met in person. Some of them I'll never meet in person. Some of them have become some of my best friends. And it's this really strange phenomenon that has happened now that we're all connected globally. When I started doing videos, it was the same kind of thing. You know, it was like introducing yourself to a whole new community all over again. And I don't make the kind of videos that most people are going to like. I'm old enough to be the mother, and in some cases the grandmother of a lot of people who post videos. And I don't have the right equipment, the best equipment. I don't know a lot of the terminology, but I can make a video and I can get it online. And I've discovered that I think because I post a video every day, some of which are extremely terrible, some of which aren't too bad, I think I have people who check it out just because I'm consistent. There's something to be said for consistency versus quality, I don't know. But, you know, I've been around now the vlogging community. When I started, there was no, vlogging was not a term. Now vlogging is a term. But I've been around the vlogging community long enough that I now have regular people that I enjoy reading. In addition to Doug and Randy, I also read Kitty Kitty, Susan's daily life with her kids. Right now she's having camera trouble, so she hasn't been posting a lot. Hasn't been posting at all because her camera's not working. But over the months, I get to know about her. I get to know about her kids. And there are other people, you know, Bicycle Sidewalk. I enjoy watching the scenes from Japan and listening to Nathan Miller talk about his life in Japan. And it's just, It's just really a cool thing, you know, to think that somebody at age 63 can become a part of something that is brand new on the internet and learn sort of more or less what I'm doing, enough to be a participant anyway, enough to have some people watch my stuff and rack my brains trying to figure out what I'm going to do tomorrow. But it's just, it's really kind of nice. I really like doing that. So anybody who's watching this, thanks a lot.